There is no rosy picture about what happened here. We're one of seven states that lost another congressional seat. 43 other states grew faster than us. We're number one, I believe, in out-migration. That includes people who died or left internationally.
Jimmy.
Yeah. And we're number four now in population. Florida has moved ahead of us. All those are terrible indicators. Now, somebody said we were only 87 individuals away from continuing the representation we have. Well, the only thing that's good in coming close is horseshoes and hand grenades, okay? When 126,000 people left this year, 180,000 people the year before, and in 2019, when the governor says it's the weather, you know where 15% of the population went? New Jersey. Now, that's not the sunny, balmy place of the Northeast, exactly. So when enough people who can afford to leave the state of New York, leave the state of New York, who's left? Middle class and lower income. $212 billion budget. Who's going to pay for the infrastructure, education, health care, our senior citizen programs, our disabled individuals? Now you add to that, the answer to what took place yesterday is 55-cent increase on a gallon of gasoline and an increase in to heat your home. I mean, that doesn't make sense. And I understand we're in a progressive state. There's one voice from one political affiliation, from one region of the state. But even a progressive agenda has to have a carve out for economic development, job creation, and small business growth. And with the population leaving the way it is now, that agenda is not there. And we need an agenda to add to that. So I don't think you can sugarcoat the good news about what took place yesterday. We're still one of seven states that lost a representative. And when the governor says, we're not getting our fair share from Washington, we lost 13 congressional seats in the last three redistrictings. This is the 14th, I believe, with this redistricting. So we're not even holding down the fort right now. We're still bleeding populations. And the answer to attracting and keeping building here is people here is you got to build an agenda that does that for their quality of life. And what took place with this gasoline tax isn't a part of that.